This video shows how to calculate the effect size Kendall's W for a Friedman test with a sufficiently low p-value in SPSS. For the more meaningful effect size calculation for post hoc tests, please refer to the video linked in the description. There are two ways to acquire Kendall's W. The first one is dividing the test statistic by the total number of observations multiplied by the number of measurements minus 1. My test summary table shows the test statistic of 28.843 and the number of observations 60. The number of measurements is 3 in my case and has to be reduced by 1. I can either do the calculation in Excel, Google Sheets or use the calculator. If you want the calculation to be as exact as possible, I would recommend using Excel or Google Sheets and copy the test statistic with all decimals available and do the calculation there. The resulting effect size Kendall's W is 0.240, rounded to 3 decimals. The second way to acquire Kendall's W is to go through Analyze, Nonparametric Tests, Legacy Dialogs, K-related samples. Put your measurements into the test variables box and select Kendall's W in the test type section. As we can see, we get the same Kendall's W we calculated by hand. For classification, use comparable studies or research field specific thresholds first and only use Cohen 92 when this is not the case. Cohen provides the thresholds 0.1, 0.3 and 0.5 for small, medium and large effects, which are also used for classification of the magnitude by this function. In my example, I have a small effect size. Please keep in mind that effect sizes for post hoc tests are much more meaningful. After all calculations are done, you need to write up the results, which is shown in the following video.